Hi guys! Welcome sa Engineered Math Channel. Sa video na to ay magre-review tayo for College Entrance Exam Mathematics. So kung gusto niyo itong matutunan, just keep on watching. Okay, so this time ay magre-review ulit tayo for College Entrance Exam Mathematics, which is part 3. So, meron na akong parts 1 at 2 sa series of this video. So, kung hindi nyo pa yung napapanood, ay ililink ko na lang para ma-check nyo. Meron din akong iba't ibang playlist ng different branch ng mathematics like algebra, geometry, trigonometry, pre-calculus, calculus, etc. na pwede nyo ring panoorin as a reference din dito sa mga tanong na sasagutan natin kasi almost lahat ng mga tanong dito is na-discuss ko na doon sa bawat playlist ko sa math. So, ililink ko na lang para ma-check nyo. Okay? So, sa part 2, nag-end tayo sa item 20. So, this time, sa part 3, magsasagot ulit tayo ng sets of questions. Let's start with question number 21. Tommy had a bag containing colored marbles. The colors are red, green, and white. There are thrice as many green marbles as red marbles and twice as many white marbles as green marbles. If a marble is drawn from the bag, what is the probability of getting a white marble? Okay, so probability. So, represent muna natin as variable yung mga different color ng marble. So, sabi dun sa second sentence, there are thrice as many green marbles as red marbles. So, therefore, green marbles is 3 times as red marbles. So, pwede natin i-let x be equal to the red marbles, yung number of red marbles. And then, dahil nga 3 times as red marbles yung green, i-represent natin yung number ng green marbles equal to 3x, right? Kasi 3 times. Tapos, twice as many white marbles as green marbles. So, yung number naman ng white marbles is twice as many as green. So, 2 times nung bilang nung green marbles. So, we have 2 times, ano ba yung representation natin sa bilang nung green marbles? 3x. So, 2 times 3x or simply, 2 times 3x is 6x. Okay? So, ang pinapahanap is probability of getting a white marble. So, ibig sabihin, probability of, let's say, event W for white marbles. Number of element for white marble over number of sample space. So, ito total natin itong x plus 3x plus 6x para makuha yung sample space. So, ilan yun? X plus 3x, 4. And then, plus 6x, 10x. Kasi yun yung total number of marbles nila, right? And then, sa numerator, ilan naman yung event ng number of white marbles? 6x, right, yung nirepresent natin. So, therefore, this is the probability. 6x over 10x. So, pwede natin makancel si x. Simply, we have 6 over 10 or in lowest term, QCF is 2. So, 6 divided by 2 is 3 over 10 divided by 2 is 5. 3 over 5. Letter A. Okay? Next, we have, if x plus y is equal to 7 and x minus y is equal to 3, what is x squared minus y squared? So, pwede natin isolve yung systems of equation dito na x plus y is equal to 7 and x minus y is equal to 3. Madali lang naman kasi 1 lang yung mga numerical coefficients nila. So, add natin para makancel si y. So, x plus x is 2x, then cancel na nga si y equals 7 plus 3 is 10. Divide both sides by 2, we have x is equal to 10 divided by 2 or 5. Then, to solve for y, let's say gamitin natin itong equation 1, y is equal to 7 transpose si x minus x. So, y is equal to 7 minus, substitute natin yung x na 5, we have y is equal to 7 minus 5 or 2. And then, tsaka natin evaluate yung pinapahanap na x squared minus y squared. So, x squared is 5 squared minus y squared is 2 squared. So, 5 squared is 25 minus 2 squared is 4. 25 minus 4 is 21. So, the answer is letter B. Okay? Next, we have 3 concentric circles whose radii are in the ratio 2 is to 3 is to 5. If the area of the smallest circle is 36 pi, What would be the area of the largest circle? So, meron daw tatlong concentric circle. So, yung ratio daw ng radius nila is 2:3:5. So, kung ililet natin na yung radius ng tatlong circles ay dun sa smallest, 2R, tapos dun sa pangalawa is 3R, then dun sa largest is 5R, we can solve for R using the area ng given smallest circle, which is 36 pi, right? Area ng circle is pi R squared. So, substitute natin yung given area na 36 pi, and then we have pi. So, yung R, i-represent natin as 2R for smaller circle. So, we have pi times quantity 2R squared. So, 36 pi is equal to pi times 4R squared. Distribute yung exponent na 2. So, cancel si pi. Matitira is 36 is equal to 4R squared. Divide both sides by 4 muna. So, we have 36 divided by 4 is 9 equal to R squared. Then, square root both sides, we have square root of 9 is 3 equals R. So, therefore, R is 3. So, para ma-solve natin yung area ng largest circle, substitute natin yung R na nakuha natin na 3 para ma-solve yung actual radius ng ating largest circle. So, 5 times R na 3 is 15. So, therefore, yung radius ng largest circle is 15. So, applying naman yung formula uli, pi R squared, we have pi times 15 squared. So, pi times 15 squared is what? 225. So, pi times 225 or 225 pi. So, therefore, the answer is letter D. Okay? Next, we have Ning is 8 years younger than her brother, Michael. 28 years ago, she was half as old as Michael. How old is Michael now? Okay, so age problem. So, si Ning daw is 8 years younger than her brother Michael. So, let X muna be the age of Michael. Para ma-represent natin yung edad ni Ning na 8 years younger than her brother Michael. So, 8 minus, dahil younger, minus age of Michael na X. Okay, so ito yung present age nila. So, 28 years ago, so in the past, so gawa tayo ng table. So, present, tapos past, or 8 years ago. So, gawa tayo ng row for Ning, tapos row for Michael. So, present age nila is si Ning X minus 8, si Michael X. So, dahil past, maminusan natin itong present age nila ng 8 para makuha yung edad nila 8 years ago. So, kay Ning, X minus 8 minus 8. Or, ilan na to? X minus 8 minus 8 is X minus 16. Then, si Michael, X minus 8 lang. Tapos, gawa tayo ng equation base dito sa second statement na 28 years ago. Ah, sorry. Bakit ako 8? 20 pala. 28 pala. Sorry. So, dapat ito is 28. So, X minus 8 minus 28 is what? X minus 36. Okay? 28 years ago. So, dahil ito yung statement natin na sa past, dito tayo kukuha ng mga variables. 28 years ago, she was half as old as Michael. So, si Ning daw, yung edad niya nung 28 years ago represented by X minus 36 is half as old as Michael. So, one half nung edad naman ni Michael 28 years ago then, which is X minus 28. So, how old is Michael now? So, solve ngayon natin tong equation for X. So, para mawala yung denominator, multiply muna natin both sides by 2. So, 2 times X is 2X, then 2 times negative 36 is negative 72 equals, so 2 times 1 half, makakancel nga si 1 half, tapos matitira is X minus 28. So, transpose ko dito si X, transpose ko dito si negative 72. So, 2X minus X is equal to negative 28 plus 72. 2X minus X is X, then negative 28 plus 72 is what? 44. So, therefore, X is 44. So, di ba nirepresent natin yun na edad na ni Michael? So, therefore, yun yung sagot. Therefore, Michael is 44 years old. Letter A. Okay? Next, we have in the figure, KLMN is a parallelogram with angle measures as mark. Find X plus Y. Okay, so ito raw yung figure natin. Tapos dun sa mga angle nitong parallelogram na given, meron tayong mga unknown variables X at Y. So, solve daw natin yung X plus Y. So, dito, dapat alam lang natin yung properties ng parallelogram para makabuo tayo ng system of equations. Kasi dalawa yung variables natin. So, kailangan natin dalawang equation. So, una equation could be, di ba yung opposite angle ng parallelogram is equal. So, therefore, we have X plus 2Y is equal to 105. And then, yung consecutive angles ng parallelogram or same side angles ng parallelogram, supplementary kasi parallel to, di ba? So, same side interior angle, parang transversal ito. So, sum nun is 180. So, x plus 2y plus 3x minus 2y is equal to 180. So, simplify natin. X plus 3x is 4x. And then, 2y minus 2y. So, makakancel pala. So, we have 4x is equal to 180. So, masasolve natin ngayon si x. Divide natin both sides by 4. X is equal to 180 divided by 4 is what? 45. So, therefore, using naman this equation, masasolve natin ngayon si y. So, x plus 2y is equal to 105. Substitute natin yung x na 45 plus 2y is equal to 105. So, transpose ko si 45. 2y is equal to 105 minus 45. So, 2y is equal to 105 minus 45 is 60. Then, divide both sides by 2 para masolve si y. Y is equal to 60 divided by 2 or 30. Okay, so meron natin value ni x na 45 at y na 30. So, add na lang natin sila kasi yun yung pinapahanap. So, 30 plus 45 is 75. Letter A. Okay? Next, we have, what is the remainder when 2x to the 4th minus x cubed plus 3x minus 1 is divided by x plus 2? Okay, so remainder theorem. So, itong polynomial, let's say, gawin nating f of x equal siya sa 2x to the 4th minus x cubed plus 3x minus 1. Tapos, itong given na divisor, so equate natin siya sa 0. So, solve natin for x. X is equal to transpose negative 2. So, para makuha yung remainder nitong polynomial na f of x, evaluate lang natin tong f of x na nasolve natin value ng x na negative 2 by remainder theorem, right? So, f of negative 2 is equal to, so pag nag-evaluate ng function, pinapalitan lang natin ng number doon sa inside ng parenthesis ng function yung bawat x dito sa ating function. So, magiging 2 times negative 2 quantity to the 4th minus negative 2 cube plus 3 times negative 2 minus 1. So, negative 2 raised to the 4th is 16. Tapos, times 2 is 32. Then, minus negative 2 quantity cube is negative 8. Then, negative pa, so positive 8 na. Plus, 3 times negative 2 is negative 6. So, minus 6 and then minus 1. So, 32 plus 8 is 40, minus 6 is 34, minus 1 is 33. Okay, so therefore, the answer is positive 33. Letter D. Okay, next we have, what is the sum of the first 6 terms of the sequence 8, negative 4, 2, negative 1? Okay, so kapag meron tayong sequence, check nyo muna kung anong type of sequence pwede siyang maging. So, now, common ratio. So, divide naman natin. So, 2 divided by negative 4 is negative 1 half. Negative 4 divided by 8 is negative 1 half then. So, therefore, it is a geometric sequence kasi may common ratio na negative 1 half. So, meron tayong formula for the sum of the geometric sequence. So, sum of n terms is equal to a sub 1 times 1 minus r raised to n over 1 minus r. Where yung a sub 1, yung first term, which in this case is 8, tapos yung r, nakuha natin na negative 1 half, and then yung n, kung pang ilang term or ilang term yung i-add natin, which is sabi 6. So, substitute natin. So, 8 times 1 minus r na negative 1 half raised to n na 6 over 1 minus negative 1 half. So we have 8 times. So 1 minus negative 1 half raised to the 6th. So parang positive na siya, di ba? 1 over 2 to the 6th or 1 minus 1 over 64 yon, right? Over 1 minus negative 1 half or plus 1 half. So magiging ano to? 1 minus 1 over 64. LCD 64, so parang magiging 64 siya sa denominator. 64 divided by ito over 1. 64 divided by 1 is 64 times 1 is 64. Minus 64 divided by 64 is 1 times 1 is 1. So parang 64 minus 1 or 63 over 64. Over 1 plus 1 half. 1 and 1 half is what? 3 halves. Right? And then, huwag natin kalimutan itong times 8. So, we have 8 times 63 over 64 times reciprocal nito kasi division 2 thirds. So, may makakancel ba? Yes, itong 2 cancel. Sa denominator, magiging ano na lang? 32. Tapos, si 3 cancel. Sa numerator, magiging ano na lang? 21. Meron pa bang makakancel? Yes, ito pa lang 8 tsaka 32 makakancel pa. So, cancel na si 8. Tapos, 32 is 4 na lang. So, the answer is, natira sa numerator is 21 over denominator natira is just 4. So, gawin nating mixed number. 21 divided by 4 is 5. 21. So, we have 5 and 1 fourth. So, the answer is letter C. Okay? Next, we have, which of the following is not a graph of a function? So, meron tayong mga graphs, tapos i-determine natin kung sino yung hindi function. So, gamit tayo ng vertical line test. So, sa vertical line test, kapag nag-intersect at least 2 points yung vertical line sa graph, then that is not a function already. So, saan sa tingin nyo kapag nag-draw tayo ng vertical line, mag-i-intersect ito ng dalawang beses at least? Obviously, itong B, right? Kasi pag nag-draw tayo ng vertical line, nag-intersect siya sa dalawa. Eh, dito naman, hindi. Dito rin, hindi. Isa lang. So, the answer is letter B. Okay? Not a function. Next, we have, find the value of the determinant 2, negative 3, 1, 1, negative 1, 1, 1, negative 1, negative 1. Okay, so determinant. So, kapag meron tayong 3 by 3 matrix, meron tayong shortcut dyan eh. So, turo ko sa inyo. Sulat nyo muna yung original na matrix. Then, ulitin nyo itong dalawa. Dalawang column na nauna. Lagay nyo ngayon dito. Tapos, draw kayo ng diagonal. 1, 2, 3. Pababa. Tapos, diagonal pataas. 1, 2, 3. Itong diagonal pababa, multiply nyo. So, 2 times negative 1 times negative 2 is what? Positive 4. Plus, negative 3 times 1 is what? Negative 3. Then, plus uli, 1 times 1 times negative 1 is negative 1. In closing sa isang parenthesis. Then, minus doon sa sum ng mga product nitong upper diagonal. So, 1 times negative 1 times 1 is negative 1. Plus, negative 1 times 1 times 2 is negative 2. Negative 2 times 1 times negative 3 is positive 6. So, plus 6. Then, simplify nyo na lang. 4 plus negative 3 plus negative 1 is 0. Right? Minus negative 1 plus negative 2 plus 6 is positive 3. So, 0 minus 3 is negative 3. So, therefore, the answer is letter A. Okay? Next, we have, given triangle ANE, if segment EM is an altitude, then triangle MEN is blank. Okay, so meron daw tayong triangle ANE, ito yon. Tapos yung segment EM daw is an altitude. So, di ba kapag altitude, perpendicular siya doon sa opposite base. So, therefore, 90 degree to. So, obviously, ano yung triangle MEN? Ito. At the right triangle kasi meron siyang 90 degree angle. So, the answer is letter C. Okay? So, putulin ko muna dito yung part 3 ng ating college entrance exam reviewer for mathematics. So, abangan nyo na lang yung next upload ko for college entrance exam reviewer mathematics part 4. Okay, so that's it for this video. So, sana ay may natutunan kayo sa video na to at maraming salamat sa panonood.